Hey everyone, it's Norm from Tested, and to wrap up this week, I have a quick and simple show and tell, maybe even a tool tip that's a follow-up on my recent projects making use of some LED lights. So a couple weeks ago, I did a project showing how to make these faux neon lights using laser cutter, although you can use CNC or even carve them by hand, with some off-the-shelf silicone tube lights that have the effect of a neon glow. And I was really pleased with this project. Seems like you guys out there liked it as well. And I read in the comments a really wonderful idea. Someone asked to make it look more like a neon light, could I wire it in a way so maybe not all the lights were connected together in series? Maybe there could be one light that was flickering, or I could do it in a way to create like a neon animation, the way you see neon lights sometimes have tubes that run in some type of sequence to create the illusion of multiple frames of animation. And totally, you can absolutely do that. It's a great idea. And so in looking at ways to control or maybe create some different effects with LED lights, you could do it very simply with a board like this. So this is Adafruit's Trinket board. It's super cheap, it's like under $10, and really powerful. Allows you to connect to ground power, has a GPIO, and runs Arduino code. So you can go into their libraries, and if you wanna do some light programming, you can script out, you know, addressable LEDs. I don't need the functionality of this. In fact, I don't even need any GPIO for the type of LED strips I'm using, because they're basically dumb LED strips. They're not individually addressable. All I need is power and ground. And so doing a little bit more research, I happened onto a company that makes this. This comes from Prop and Scenery Lights. They're a company out of the Midwest, I believe Michigan, and they make lighting products for theatrical installations and presentations, for theater, essentially, which they often do need lights. And they have an off-the-shelf turnkey connector here that is a barrel connector, and much like you would have, for example, a dimmer that could be connected, that connects from your power to what you would plug into your LED strip. You could also string along this, which has a built-in controller as well as buttons that then give you the ability to have a variety of effects. And they sell, I believe, three different versions of this. I bought a few to try them out. There's one that allows for more like flame lights, flame-like lighting effects. So if you want your LED lights to simulate the kind of pulsing glow of, you know, embers in the flame, or candlelight or campfire, you can plug this into just the barrel connector. So here I have power, 12 volts to a dimmer, standard dimmer, and then this connector here, and I'll plug it into my neon light, and I'll bring it up to you. Now, the exposure of this is that is such that it's pretty bright already, but I think you can see some of this pulsing effect. And if I press the different mode buttons, there you go. That's a different pulsing effect for sure. And there's also a speed button, so I can change between different speeds, I believe 10 different speeds, and also a dedicated brightness button as well, if I want to just tune the brightness without having to use that dimmer. But this is a super neat little off-the-shelf plug-and-play device that has the functionality that I might want to create just a little more life into these lighting projects. For example, I have my lightsaber stand that I made a couple weeks ago as well. And if I plug in this other plug-and-play connector. This one is one for more blinking and strobe effects, which I thought could be cool. I can plug that in, and you can get what looks like, you know, a shorted electrical signal or, you know, a strobe light. And just like the other connector, there are three buttons on here. You can change your different between different modes. So here's a more steady strobe, as well as a second button to adjust the speed of the effects. So a very slow blink to a much faster blink, and we can cycle through. And this one has pulsing effects as well, which I think is super cool. I love the idea that this connector, which goes for under $10, you can buy them in multiple packs. And if you pair them with like a barrel connector splitter, then you can wire up your lighting projects so that different parts of your lights and your signs, your signage that you're making, or whatever you're making, can have different effects. And while it's not programmable, it's not as robust as if you go with a microcontroller, it is something that just works immediately. And for my purposes, it's just something that's nice to have for all types of prop and diorama projects. And speaking of dioramas and signage, I was trying to come up with a new project that would let me test and have fun with this controller. And I ended up wanting to do something in sixth scale, because That's my jam. And I wanted to also try, instead of using the silicone LED lights, doing something that would be a smaller scale. So I turned to the COB chip-on-board LED strips that I talked about a couple weeks back as well. And the idea that I settled on is inspired from the world of Blade Runner. And if you remember toward the end of the film, Deckard's fighting with Roy Batty, and they're on a rooftop, and behind them, the backdrop, they're beautifully lit by the side of the building, which has this TDK electronics company in the logo in a neon light. And I've always loved the look of that sign. I think it makes a really interesting, recognizable backdrop in that world. So I went to the laser cutter and cut out a couple pieces of acrylic, designed in Illustrator. And what I ended up doing was then kind of taping the COB LED strips and doing a little bit of that LED strip origami and routing them around the shape of the letters. This is the K of that TDK. And I found red and also white colored LED strips, so that should be just fine. And then to get that neon shape, because it's not very malleable here, and you can tell that the corners are kind of ragged, what I decided to do was just create a mask. So also laser cut the shape, then that's gonna go on top and allow only the light I want to pass through. Also wired it with a couple different inputs, so then I can mix and match these little controllers. And I have basically four different inputs. We'll try some flickering, we'll try some pulsating lights. Again, trying to give some life to this neon so it's not just a static light at different brightnesses. So let's do some photos, let's capture some video. I'm gonna grab some six scale stuff that might be thematically in this realm and appropriate, and head over to the photo set.